When using raster entity manipulation to edit raster images, you will typically follow several key steps. First, you will need to create a raster entity. You can use any one of these three types of raster entities. First is regions, enhanced regions, and primitives. These are all available on the raster entity manipulation REM panel of the raster tools tab. Once you have created a raster entity, you can edit the entity using the AutoCAD editing tools as well as some tools specific to raster entity manipulation. Once this is done, you will select the editing entities and choose one of the several options. If you wish to select all raster entities at once, you can use the select all button on the REM panel. Alternatively, you can use AutoCAD selection methods, including window crossing, to select an entities of raster images. After you have selected the entities, you can then choose to remove these entities in one of these two ways panel. The simplest is to clear them with one of the clear commands in REM panel. Do this if you do not want to save changes or if you actually have not changed the raster entity itself. This can occur if you can use the copy command, the original does not change and can be cleared. Alternatively, you can use merge tool, which is available on REM panel. It will take all of the changes and essentially burns into them underlying raster image. To see how this works, let's look at an example which includes a variety of building details on a plan sheet on raster image format. Assume you will like to move one of the details to provide some rooms for new work. On the REM panel, expand the create region and select rectangular. Select the index finger details so it can be modified. Now click on home tab. From the modify panel, use the AutoCAD move command. Select the raster entity manipulation that you have just created recently and move it to the right side slightly. Once the editing are completed, go back to the raster tools tabs in the REM panel. Click merge to raster image, which will bunch those changes back to the underlying raster image. Select entity, enter. Next, expand the enhanced region drop down and use enhanced region drop down to select a region. These regions are only available when using bitonal images. Again, you can choose regions using windows or crossing, but in this example, click on connected entity. Click anywhere in the model, wrap, replate, and you will see that the particular detail highlighted. Raster design finds all of the raster data associated with that part. Then go back to the home tab, modify panel, choose copy command. Select the raster entity, enter, and copy to the right side. Now go back to the raster entity tools tabs and click on merge to raster image and select this object, enter. Since the original was not modified, you can clear all to raster entity manipulation. You may wondering why some changes are not just performed with simple raster editing tools rather than created raster entities, then performing editings. then merge raster entities back to the raster data. The main value in performing these additional steps is realized when you can modify raster data as it is where not vector data. This may become clear in another example. You can modify just a portion of a copy that you had created by using primitive. Again, primitive can only be modified using the bitonal images. Expand the create primitive dropdown and select circle. Select the inner circle of the new copy in the model detail so that only this portion of the detail is now raster entity. Click it again and use raster grip editing to enlarge this circle slightly. Once this is done, merge it back to the underlying raster information. Now you can see how raster entity manipulation can be used to modify raster data, much like you will be find the modified vector data.